The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tiger Technician Hour with your host, Basil Chapman. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, Basil Chapman.
Hi, folks. Basil Chapman, Tiger Technicians Hour. My pleasure to be here Monday through Friday, 11 o'clock till noon. I've also been trying to fill in for Larry. Larry's on vacation, so I'm doing the 9 o'clock till 10 o'clock show. Did it today, do it tomorrow. And let's go straight to the nitty-gritties. E-mini is up $8.50. This is very important. It's in leg C in the 120-minute chart. It's in leg D in the weekly chart. Leg B, I believe, in the monthly chart. And it is going to a leg possibly G/B in the daily chart. So let me just run the numbers because there are a lot of things I need to talk about. Dow's up 107 at 18,603. Just an eye blink away from 18,623, which starts at leg D, the missing leg D in the Dow. Actually, I'll do the charts at the same time. Here we go. INDU. So the Dow is making a leg, possibly a leg E in the 120-minute chart. It'll be a leg E if it goes to 18,623 in the weekly chart. And in the daily chart, you've got 106.49, up 106. And it will be a leg D if it goes above 18,622. And that's going to be very important. The MACD is finally at 80%. The stochastic's finally at 80%. The MACD has not yet crossed positive. And the way that's good and the way it's bad, I'll get to talk about it in a moment. Let's just go on. We've got the SPX.X trading up 9, a little bit behind the Dow. Let's say the Dow's up 0.50%. 57%, and the S&P is up 0.47. Now what we've got is the S&P, if it breaks to a new high above 2187.66 by one penny, it goes to F/B in the Chapman wave as an alternate count. But everything about it would suggest that if it holds very nicely above this 9-period exponential moving average, we could rotate between with new daily highs, with short pullbacks and short upward moves with slightly higher highs, higher lows. The whole thing breaks down in the next week, next 3 to 5 trading days, if the S&P, which is at 2184, closes under 2160. Just make it real simple. All right. The QQQ series, 117.08. Now, this is what I mean. There's a really good chance that this doesn't have any of the characteristics of a G right now. I'm going to put a G/C in the Chapman wave methodology. Those of you who understand it know very well what I'm talking about. Let me just quickly show you something here. I'll move it over. This is a chart that I forgot to send to subscribers, but I have sent it. This is a 120-minute chart. I'd spent ages working on it and forgot to send it, but I posted it less than an hour ago. And it shows you what I was expecting. And I'll go to the real thing in a moment. I just wanted to go to this chart here, which shows in a very simple way the concept of the Chapman wave. Find the lowest, most identifiable lowest low. And then what we need to see is peak A, B, C, D alphabetically up with uppercase letters on the upside and lowercase on the downside. When you get to D, other things can happen. And I'll show you enough charts to show you that D is very important because it could break out, start a brand new buy mode. It could recycle, as this might be happening right now in the QQQ series, up 49 cents. Leg, I have to call this a leg D/B in the weekly chart. And definitely it's a B. There's no other way to count it in the monthly chart. I have to tell you, the reason why I wanted to have this webinar coming up on Tuesday night, it's called New Highs to Come, a 90-minute live event with Basil Chapman, August the 16th. There it is. And so join me. If you, it's a subscriber event only, but you can become a trial subscriber, just a free trial for a month by joining. All the implications of deflation to inflation, the implications of all the building that's going up on here in the Northeast. I'll start talking a lot more about the coda phase that I believe we're in. Coda meaning final phase. And that's with all the negative and actually all the positive implications as well. So this is going to be a really one of my most important webinars in terms of timing, not timing entries and entrances, timing in terms of discussing. It's something that I've been waiting to see for forever. I mean, for a long, long time. And it's going to be a very important in terms of discussing it, because these are the icons you'll be able to see. They're happening now. I used to send them out every 3 months or 4 months, now every month. And all of a sudden, over the last couple of weeks, it's almost every week I'm showing you new things that are really important. So let's go on. Let's go to the gold. Gold is, at this point, it's up $6 at $13.58. This is a very important move for gold, because if gold can break above yesterday's high of, where were we? 1363.6 on the continuous contract. There's a real good chance it will again tackle this, what I call the Chapman wave. Let me draw it for you. Green would implicate upside potential, and red suggests that there's the Chapman wave inside track repellent zone kicking in. Or let's call it pink, because I don't want to mix pinks and reds. Here we go. I mean, reds and reds. So this is the area where it keeps getting, gold keeps getting repelled in the daily chart. If it can break through and hold, get to the 1372.73 area, there's a good chance it's going to go to a leg D. But at the same time, a leg D, a buy mode within the previous, below a previous peak, has other implications. And that implies that the weekly chart, which is bumping into that resistance, Chapman wave inside track resistance area, is going to be very important. Let's go on looking at, oh, I'll just do this quickly. Someone reminded me. Thank you very much. Completely forgot. Here's the two-minute E-mini. Now, you don't want that. You want the 10-minute. Let me just show you the 10-minute, right? Is this a 10-minute? No, here's a 10-minute. Mm-hmm. Right here. No, it's a 5-minute. That's a 5-minute. Made a peak in. It's pulling back a little bit. I want the 10-minute, because the 10-minute has an alternate count, 10-minute count that I need to show. Yeah. F/A. If this is an A, it's only going to be a confirmed an A, because you go decisively above 2182.75. Remember that whole 2183's area was a very strong resistance. Now we've gone above it. We've pulled back. I mean, we've gone to it and pulled back. You want to see a real smash to the a breakout, a rocket ship to the upside, just as we had after the the oil, natural gas, some figures came out economic at 10:30. So okay, so this is going to be very important, and the support that needs to hold would be 2180 to 2179 on the E-mini. All right, here we go. We're looking at gold. We're looking at silver. SI, I haven't updated that for a little while. Silver, yeah, it's the same choppy within a range. But if silver can break to 20.55, it's at 20.26 right now. That'll be positive. Both of them, if they break below yesterday's lows, very negative. Not very negative. It means they're stuck in the trading range. That takes me to the dollar before we go to a break. Let me go to the dollar. Here we go. Dollar, look at that. Dollar's pulling back. It's making that H pattern. I always talk about the H pattern. It's a formidable pattern. Let's go to the TLT, because the TLT is also both the dollar, gold, and bonds have been stuck in a trading range. And I think that by Monday or Tuesday of next week, a lot of things are going to be changing. I'll be right back, Basil Chapman, and we'll refresh the charts as soon as I get back.
Today, it's hard to tell if the economy is coming or going. Regardless, I want my money going in the direction I choose. If that's your stance as well, then you want to know how EverBank can help keep your money thriving just the way you want. Is growing your money a priority? EverBank is committed to a yield pledge promise to pay high yields on your checking, money market, and CD balances. Looking to diversify? EverBank ingeniously developed accessible ways to spread your money around the world into foreign currencies and even non-FDIC insured metals. And when it comes to your wealth, they bring a highly experienced and global perspective to help you manage it. EverBank's financial philosophy flies in the face of the status quo. They believe your money's performance should not be determined by today's economic circumstances, but by the drive to rise above them and create opportunities that favor your objectives. If that excites you like it does me, call 1-855-750-4051 to find out what they can do for you. That's 1-855-750-4051. Call them today. EverBank is a member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns, as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com. The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now.
Basil, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Hi, folks, we're back. I wanted to do this because I forgot to send this out to my subscribers this morning. I'd spent so much time on it, and then the last minute, I started working on the futures, the Dow futures, because it showed something, because it was live, it was actionable overnight, etc. And it demonstrated what I wanted to show, why I was still bullish and why we still have bullish positions, only bullish positions, and why we are still long the Dow from last Wednesday, I believe it is. And I hope that stays because I raised the stop a lot. We'll see. But this is the 120-minute Dow chart, and I did a little Elliott wave. I'm not going to get into that now. That it was a 5 to the top at 18,622 on the 20th of July, and I called it a 5 to the bottom at 18,247 around about the 2nd, 3rd of August. And now we've gone, and I had this as a 3 at peak C, and I changed it last night and spent a lot of time explaining it. And one of the things that I did, let me just show you the chart right here. So remember, this is the Dow. We look for at least a peak D. And what I wanted to do was just to go to this chart, right? That's the one. So that's what I had all ready to send last night. And it was right there. And I changed to say, I think that this is going to be 4 right here. And anyway, Elliott Wave 5 will be there. But I've in a way stopped really. I shouldn't even talk about it as Elliott Wave because I've modified it so much now because there's a, funnily enough, there's a little coda section that occurs, Elliott Wave within an Elliott Wave, which is really very close to the Chapman Wave methodology. So I don't even know what the relationship anymore to the Elliott Wave is. So what it said was that there should be another zigzag move to the upside, and that should take me to a culmination, and that will be above Dow 18,622. Where are we now? We're at 18,605. High today of 18,610.95. We are just an eye blink, 13 points away. At this point, it's more. It's we've got to get to 23. So it's 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 14 points and away from the all-time high in the Dow. Now, what's really important about this is that there was a one-to-one relationship. That's that the dashed line right there. There's a left side, right side. If I want to be very strict and take it to the low, I can't take it after that. It takes me out to the 15th, but it could happen earlier. It could happen quicker. That's very important. That is getting to the left side high of peak F. And it really can't be a G. It has to be, now I've got full wave count here, A, B, C, D, and this is leg E to the upside. So this is very nice. I like the action, thank goodness. And let me show you something else that also is very important within the context of what I look at in terms of the Dow, to keep it as simple as possible. Let me just go to this. This is the Dow daily chart. So I discussed how it could be a peak C1 at 18,622. You remember yesterday we discussed that? What I was looking for was 18,585 could be a peak C2. But look at held by the end of the day. It held the 9-period moving average, that maroon color. The MACD is still turning up. It hasn't crossed positive yet. If it does cross positive, that's going to be even more of a trigger to the upside. And the stochastic, finally, yesterday when I showed it, was like at 78% or something, the stochastic. Now 76%. Now it's at 80.64. This is nice action, but the day is young. There's not even 2 hours into the day. Now let me squeeze this chart so that I can show you something even more exciting. If you want to be bullish, if you want to be bearish, you have to look for a deflection of the MACD down. Stochastic has to plop way down into the 68% area. As the price goes plummets two times, it's not one, you're going to have two sessions closing below the 9-period exponential moving average of 18,497. Just trying to be as clear as I can so that you know what I'm looking at, why I'm looking at it. Now, you've got something else going on in the 2-minute chart of the YM and the 2-minute chart of the ESU. There could be an alternate count going to a D instead of a C in the 2-minute count. If you want to be very strict, this is C, but if you want to use the Chapman wave phantom peak, that could have been a phantom peak, so that's a D. But what happens is that if we go to a higher high, you might even find that it's that was a D, and this is a brand new C in the YM. But the S&P, that's the one I really stick to much closer. It's what I trade. This is what I like. This is going to be very important because a close below 2180 on this 2-minute chart suggests, that was a D, and now you're going to have to rebuild some strength to be able to get those extra points in the Dow. Enough. Let's go to our story, and we want to look at bonds pulling back, the relationship of the where is it? I want to quickly do copper, because copper had a nice move intraday. Yeah, but it's just within the context of that candle. Steve gave a great webinar last night on candles. But this candle right here, I call it a Chapman wave inverted Roman candle. You've never heard of those things in any of Steve Nissen's book or anybody else. But this suggests that if copper can hold, it's not doing it now, it's at 2.188. If it can get to 2.191, and then hold for about 2-3 hours, that would say, hey, it's a good chance that tomorrow we actually try to test the high of yesterday. But pulling back like this, got to watch it closely. I just think copper's in a trading range, just like the other indices, the commodities we're looking at now, and that's interest rates, gold, and dollar. Okay, now comes the story. My Dow quartet, GE, has been performing horribly, and even now it's down 2 cents at 31.25. It is just acting, it was a superb leader. Now it's suggesting, be careful, that if the Dow does make its leg D to the upside above 18,622, there are other contingencies that you've got to be looking at. Let me go to IBM. IBM, of course, one of the great stocks on the stock market, coming back. It's about to test its monthly, very long-term downtrend line. It's up to at 164.21. I'm going to call this I'm going to call this E/B. I really should call it B, but I haven't got this MACD strong enough and the stochastic over 67%, so I'm going to be a little cautious. I'm calling it an alternate wave E, maybe a B, nothing wrong with it, and it's gone to an E in the weekly charts. Now, when you go very quickly from a D to an E in a weekly chart, unless there's a very strong breakout to the upside, you've got to be a little bit careful, especially when you've just crossed over the 200-period moving average, which you haven't even seen for almost a year. This is very important. So IBM is a tell for us. Triple M, right now it's up $1.92. This is a brand new move, ABC, but it's under the previous peak C that failed. So you might get an overlapping wave. That gives us time to the upside. It says, hey, if Triple M, which has been an absolute leader in the Dow for a very long time, making an all-time high just last month, How it participates in this move now is going to be so important. And if you're talking about UTX, of course, I'm only talking Dow stocks right now. I'm going to get to the others in a moment. UTX, it hasn't got to an all-time high at all. All-time highs, way at 124. It plummeted down to the 84 area, 83, 839 actually. And now it's at 108.93. The monthly chart's improved a lot. The weekly chart has improved a lot. Very quick, D to E. Oh, I have to tell you, next week's going to be so... My webinar on Tuesday night, the timing for this in the market was... It was intentional, but the real timing was this coda phase. And all I can say is, there's going to be so much to discuss. It's going to be so important to your portfolio and my portfolio, everybody's portfolio. What happens after that? When do we get that sharp sell-off? And then when do we get the next big move to the upside? I'll be back very soon, straight after this break. In fact, Dow's up 113.
Platinum, grains, crude oil, gold, copper, cattle, hogs, gasoline, natural gas, coffee, cotton, cocoa, and sugar. These are just some of the commodities mentioned in the most recent issue of Andy Hecht's Technomental Commodity Report. Andy publishes his weekly newsletter every Thursday morning, where he breaks down the commodity market and provides his subscribers with specific trading recommendations based on his trading methodology. By signing up for a free trial to the Technomental Commodity Report, you'll get a full 30 days to try out this powerful newsletter service and see for yourself the types of trades Andy has recommended for his subscribers. When you sign up for a 30-day free trial, you're under no obligation to pay anything. And should you decide to continue, you will lock in the low rate of only $79 a month. Sign up right now for the Technomental Commodity Report and make sure you're ready to catch the next big trade in commodities. For more information and to get started today, visit the front page of TFNN.com. Many of our new listeners have heard about the Tiger's Den, but wondered, what exactly is it? The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of your favorite TFNN shows, plus see all the charts as they happen live during those shows and have access to all those charts. You can test drive the Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days. It will greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets. Details on the Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN is excited to offer a brand new piece of market scanning software unlike anything the industry has ever seen. John Logan and his team have spent years developing their market profile tools to finally be able to release the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. And right now, you can get a two-week trial absolutely free just by visiting TFNN.com and providing us your name and email address. The TAS Profile Scanner Plus is the premier market profile-based scanner in the industry, powered by the acclaimed TAS proprietary algorithms. This feature-rich scanner is a standalone desktop software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Within 3 minutes of signing up, you can have the software downloaded and running on your computer with a complete roadmap of market indicators and inflection points to trade off using the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. Sign up today and try this amazing piece of software by visiting TFNN.com.
Tiger TV is an exciting way to experience TFNN programming. See high-definition video giving you crystal-clear charts, as well as seeing some of the faces of TFNN's highly acclaimed financial experts with crisp, full-fidelity sound. Catch Tom O'Brien, John Logan, Steve Rhodes, Basil Chapman, Larry Pesavento, Think or Swim, David White, Andy Hecht, and Daryl Martin in crystal-clear, high-definition audio and video. Tiger TV, exclusively at TFNN.com. This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
All right, folks, here's the SPY, the 5-minute SPY, that's green. The red is the USO, United States Oil Fund. Look what happened this morning. Crude starts moving up. SPY goes to a peak D 5 minutes, and then plop, comes down. It was at 10 o'clock or something, and then starts a brand new move. And looks to me like this isn't an E, could be a brand new A. If there is going to be, there are so many people that I got messages all over the show, wherever I was. For this is from Market Play, this is not from the layperson. who said, short, we're short, we're going short, we are short. And I'm saying to myself, did I do something wrong? I mean, we are long, and I'm looking at the upside. Is it? Am I mistaken? And the more I did the analysis, the more I said, I can only answer that question if we do get to Dow 18,623. But I would suggest to you that crude oil, I don't know what the story is, why it's doing what it's doing, but the HO, which is, what was the question? Julie asked about HO, reversal day. Yeah, this is very good action. This is leg B in the day. Remember I said that crude oil, unless crude oil can make that V-shaped pattern, it doesn't have time to go sideways. Why is it not coming up? Do it again. Oh, that's because, oh man, did I mess that up again? Yes, I did. You can't mix. Let me just do this for 1 second. Spy there. That's all right, fixed. Good. Yeah, you don't have time. So that V-shaped pattern was already taking a little bit too much time. So crude oil, to be positive, crude oil cannot break underneath 40.70. It's at 43.16, up $1.45. And it cannot close under, let me make sure that I got that number right. It cannot close under 41. If it does that, that's an H pattern. It's going to retest the lows. However, if it does take out 43.52 for new leg B, that's really important. Why? Because if you're looking at the USO, remember we're looking at the 5 minute, but if you're looking at the USO, the MACD and stochastic have actually been rising very well. The CCI is moving well. The unbalanced volume is moving well. Unbalanced volume needs to catch up. But what's really important is if the USO can break above 1024. No, I'm sorry. If it can get to 1037, 1041 by tomorrow, it doesn't have to close there. It's just got to hit that number. Why? Because it's starting to do a couple of things. First of all, you see that gap at 1030 on the 22nd of July? I want to be into that candle, and I'd love to be above that candle. That's number one. Number two is I want to see the 9-period moving average actually start this leg B and continue this leg B as a moving average, and that would be very positive. Then 1055 is the 9-period exponential moving average in the weekly. All right, enough with that. Let's get back to our nitty-gritty. What did the Dow do? What was the high? The high was 18,617. You're teasing me. I don't like that. I need 5 points. 6 points. 6 points. And this candle is beautiful. This is one of those days in candle patterns. I don't believe last night Steve spoke about that because he was really talking about end points, turning points at the top and the bottom mostly. But this kind of candle, you see these big white candles? There are some days, I don't know if this is going to be the day, but we did see it just recently, that big surprise to the upside. You remember on that Friday, was it? On the 5th, where we opened and where we closed. We opened at the low and we closed at the high exactly. So there's a chance that we could do that today. I just don't know if we can do it a second time in a row, but certainly the shorts are getting real squeezes here as a big surprise. Right through the early morning, it looked like, big deal. So it moved up a little bit, and then you started to pull back, and then zap. So this is going to be very important. I want to see that moving average actually cross with a wide, I call it beta, I think it's a theta, I'm not sure, with the wide distance between the green faster moving average and the slow red one. That to me would be really positive, like it did there. Okay, then I had a quick question. I had a question which might have a quick answer, might not. Is this the time to buy GTR's XRT? I did this during Larry's show earlier this morning because Macy's had a huge move to the upside. So I was looking at it and I said, well, it depends what happens. I'm going to only be able to call this a leg F/B if it goes above. I need to see how it closes. The weekly is just above the trend line. This is the S&P Spider. But the Spider is not really the one that I like. It's the RTH. That is the index that is way, way better. Now, if this was Friday, I'd be real nervous. I did this earlier on. I said, it looks to me like the RTH is making a pattern that some of us who use the Chapman Wave methodology are really familiar with. It's called the Chapman Wave Stalk Leg Formation. Woohoo! 18,625, all-time high in the Dow. Thank you. Yes, leg D has begun. And now we've got to be a little careful just in the analysis. So here's your leg in the RTH, the Market Vectors Retail ETF, trading at 18.98 up 51 cents. Why did I do that? I did this before that bar. I did it earlier at between the 9 and 9.30 time frame when I did Larry's show this morning. And I said that there's a Chapman wave methodology, a technique that I call the stalk leg formation, where there's a long leg to the upside. It's made up of many peaks. It's just a long stretch to the upside, pretty much straight up. Then you go sideways for a period of time, and then you break out. Well, we've seen that with the leg, the body, that then what happens is it stalls, and then it goes into a body formation. It must be an oval. It can't be a rectangle. If that body gets broken, the head of the body, if the top of the body, the oval body, in this case, 80.86 gets broken, you start the neck. I did it in a light color, saying I can only do it, and usually I do it in pink, so let me go back to pink. So now you can see why, in timing, I wanted to do my webinar on this coming Tuesday. There is so much to discuss. There are so many aspects that are going to be so important. We're going to be looking at sectors that could participate. I think steel needs to have a rest after such a huge move. Now the question is this E or is this E/B? Well, we have to let it play out. And at this particular point, I'm putting both notations because I feel strongly that it's got the pattern. This is the neck. We have to wait for the head to form, and then the beak comes back and retests the body high. In this case, 80.20, what did I say it was? 80.86. No big deal about that. So the higher it goes, the better it is. And what happens? A quick peak D to a peak E, you got to watch out, except for one variation. If E is strongly higher than D, something else has happened. It might be a recycle. Is this a breakout move today? I really don't want to. I don't want to get into anything like that. I do want to say Macy's had a big spike to the upside. Oh, I didn't finish my sentence. I said if this was a big gap up to a leg E or F on a Friday, I usually get kind of nervous. I don't like that. I don't care what the story is. I'm usually a little nervous about that. But this is a Thursday, so there's a difference. Now have a look at this. This is Macy's. Macy's was looking horrible. It made a leg D, quick ABCD in the weekly chart once, pulled back sharply to a new low, and went on again ABC, and then we waited and waited. And I looked at the monthly chart. It went from the 73s all the way down to the 30 level, just under 30, and then it popped to 39. It popped to the 35-ish area, 37, and then it pulled back. So this move now in Macy's is really important, even though it's because they're cutting back 100 stores or something like that. So someone says front-running retail sales. So the question was, do we buy CJP and JWM ahead of earnings? Man, I tell you, let's have a look at those. That is JCPenney, I believe. Let's see, JCP. I'll do that. Basil Chapman, Tiger Conditions Hour, all-time highs, 18,827. Be back.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit tfnn.com.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up to the date, accurate, active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. Until recently, it was almost impossible for the average investor to hedge against currency risk in Europe or Japan. For a bold trade on Europe or Japan that protects against moves in currency, trade HEGE or HEGJ, 2x currency hedged leveraged ETFs from Direction Investments. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
This segment is brought to you by TFNN. Test drive all the newsletters for free at TFNN.com.
So let me just do this real quickly, because I just want to show, well, J.C. Penney, to answer the question, I'm done with that front running, trying to pick whether or not they're going to, which way stocks will respond if with earnings. We've had 3 great moves to the upside, 1 slam to the downside for my traders corner. We're lucky the slam to downside was the day after we took profits, some profits, and then the stop should have been hit. If it wasn't, it was still just a very small loss. So I just don't know. I look at the chart, and it's the chart that tells me, and J.C. Penney is in leg D in the weekly, but under the previous major high, it's got an H pattern that goes to an M. I think it should be quite good, but maybe not. I don't know. All I can say is that the way it's acting right now, if it wasn't earnings, whenever that's coming out, I'd say this is very good. At 986, I'd have a stop at $9.20, because the bigger picture says it's trying to make higher highs and higher lows, and that's all I can tell you. So that's that. Now, the other thing is, this is the period, it's always toughest for me. Why? I had a projection, and the projection is hit. Now, what happens with subscribers is that I've written in that if such and such happens after, only after, not before, but after going to the all-time high, be prepared to do something different. And we've got that preparation already if it happens. That's number one. Number two is, now it's really incumbent upon me to say, okay, so it's D, what now? This is very difficult. This is where the ebullience from hitting a target is essentially moderated by saying, okay, now what? Now you're back, I'm at square one now. I have to now say, okay, now what do we do to handle the trade? Well, that's the easy part, because all I have to say is raise the stops. So that's all we're going to do. I don't have to make other decisions. But what it does say to me is, this is not what everybody's looking at. Remember, I focused for 30, I don't know how long, years daily, making a call on the Dow. I used to do it before CNBC took over all those smaller programs, the Financial News Network, I think it was called. I used to make a daily call here in Boston. By 9:25, they had the information that give a call on the day. So this is the tough part. Why? Because let me explain why. And this is what I was going through with in Larry's show, the QQQ series. This is just a modest look. Peak A is a peak E was right there at 100. What are we doing for time? Oh, we've got time. Peak E was just 117.04. Pulls back just intraday. I mean, intra bar. It's called the inside day. Makes just a nominal high of 117.29. Pulls back today, just goes to another nominal high, 117.37. Working really hard. The IBB is only up $1.80. It's had a big move down from the 299.48 high that was made at peak E, and it hasn't really responded all that well. It's in that pattern, as I said, it can go to an H and then can go to an M, lowercase m pattern. It's just, it's going to be tough decisions here. And look at the pattern I'd already drawn in for subscribers to demonstrate a turnaround situation, that inverted V, and it's sticking there. It hasn't broken the resistance line. Look at the IWM. Holding the 9-period moving average, but only up 0.57. Dow's up 0.68. S&P's up 0.51. So these things are not really breaking out. So this is where other things can happen. Remember, what is the objective? It's to get to a certain point, to leg D in this case, in the weekly chart, in the IWM. Look at the New York Stock Exchange. This one has got, finally, it made its leg D. It looked impossible back when I took a vacation and I was watching this daily, just every day, lower highs, lower lows, lower, nothing big. And then it made the pattern that I call Chapman Wave Falling X, lower descending cone, declining cone formation. And now it's gone to the D. And I've got an alternative count in the weekly that says, wait a minute, it's a G or a B. You're not going to break down at a G or a B if the MACD and stochastic are strong. This is it. Difficult. Why? Because to put it together with areas of weakness and areas of strength, look at the SLX, which is the Vector Van Eck, Vector Steel ETF, had a fantastic move, a double from 1530 to 32, and now it's resting. So this is where other decisions have to be made very selectively. So, yes, and I just got an email. In fact, just as I started this, I looked over and it says, as Dow goes up today, the QQQs are falling on extremely light volume. Be careful being so bullish. So I'm pleased that I was able I wouldn't temper the bullishness, of course. And why shouldn't I be bullish? It got exactly to the target I had, which looked almost impossible at one point. But once that's done, cold shower, you start fresh. Cold shower, start fresh. I don't know, whatever that means. Now, let's go to the XLF. The XLF, which we have a small long position in, just a little bit, what, 23.99? It's down 3 cents from our entry point. This is struggling. And one of the reasons could be that interest rates are not spiraling to the upside, so the banks can really make a fortune. And this is a position that I'd love to add to it, because I'd like to think of it as the next big move to the upside. But if you put it together with what is needed, and what is needed really is to have the sense that higher rates will be coming. And so far we don't really have that, because look at the TNX, that's the 10-year, that's the more important one out of the three. It's just stuck in this range. And in fact, it's just been making lower lows. The monthly still looks terrible. The Japanization of our bond yield is continuing. So this is where decisions have to be made. This is also where, I was asked about Chapman Wave Stork Leg. Could I give an example? I've got a lot of examples. I'll give you an example, because I believe that this is going to be pulling back. It's one that we've had for a while. We bought it at 10, 10 and a half, something like that, and it's trading at 12 and a half. This is MWA. It is Mueller Water Products. There's the leg. I showed this to subscribers. Actually, I did it at my webinar last in June, first week of June. I showed this and we got into it. So we've had it for a while because I think it's in the right area. There's the leg, Chapman Wave Stork Leg Formation. There's the body and there's the breakout, the neck. And this pattern, if anybody knows stocks like Apple or the QQQs, the ones that have just gone up, or what is the other water one? This is MWA. The other one is, anyone remind me, what's that fantastic water stock, water products as well? It's the leader of the group. I usually know these letters. Anyway, so that's the stork leg formation. Then what happens is the neck completes. It sometimes can just revert immediately to AWK. Thank you. AWK, I'll do that in a second. And then starts the beak formation. The beak goes all the way back to the breakout of 10.54 or lower. So this is a pattern that we follow very closely. And then when it's finished, it has another spectacular move to the upside in this Chapman Wave. There's that beeper. I'm going to keep it. I think I'm attached to it. Oh, but I'd like to get it off. There. So we're about to go for a break. The Dow is up 130 at 18,625. That's quite something. Anyway, this is leg D in the daily chart of the MW, and now it's a little tough to get into it here. You have to wait for a pretty nice pullback. I'll be back. Basil Chapman, Tiger Technician's Hour, and wow, historic day, all-time high in the Dow. That is very nice.
I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
In quiet markets, investors search for new trading opportunities. We'd like to introduce you to a new product that provides opportunities even in flat markets. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a new and innovative Chicago-based exchange registered with the Commodity Futures Trading Commission. And unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their trading platform. Nadex never charges a fee to use their platform, which even includes real-time charts and full customization capability. Nadex's unique short-term binary options allow traders and investors to capitalize on strategies even when the underlying markets are quiet. Nadex's innovation has allowed them to come up with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com, or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors.
TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
Learn how to trade options with Swim Lessons. Brought to you by TD Ameritrade. Think or swim. Next on TFNN.
Hi, folks. We're back. I just wanted to show the S&P 5-minute chart. There's a pattern that we're looking at. Let me just do this here. Using the low, the exact low of 1140 on the S&P cash, remember it doesn't trade overnight, so that's that big gap over there. We got a peak ABCD. What did we look for? D's, and now it's gone to AB, and now, sorry, E slash A and F slash B. I don't, because it's hit that high of 2187.66, the high today is so far 2187.26. Because this is a futures trades in fractions. So this has kind of accomplished everything that you would want to see. And we've gone to the D, so in the Dow. So this says, okay, at this particular point, now you've got to start calculating. And when I say calculating, what I imply by that is you have to start saying, if a goal is achieved, essentially what you do is you have to either take it off the table or it becomes part of a two or three prong attack, and therefore this is the first one or the second, whatever it is. And this says that at this point, with leg D in the this MWA in the daily, leg C, G/C maybe in the weekly, leg B in the monthly, stock like this, or the XLF acting okay, but really not, where did it go to? XLF not really leading. It says, hey, this is part of the process. And so far, as I said to my subscribers this morning and yesterday, we've not got the bad news. You've got to have the bad news with what's missing. What haven't I discussed today that I always discuss for years and years and years? We've been looking at the VIX index. And the VIX is below the 13s. It's at 11.59. The VIX on a weekly basis and a monthly basis is saying, I'm in the area that's very bullish, but I'm also in the area where don't over-anticipate bad things. Anything can happen. Hey, Charlie in Framingham, we've just got a moment. What would you like to look at?
I'm long UCO. I'm just wondering where it's going,
okay.
If you can tell.
Yeah, I can tell you just two things. Listen to my preamble before about the crude oil, and listen to it what I was talking about the USO, because that's obviously your route, right? So I'm going to just say to you and make it real simple. You are long. You want to see USO. This is the two times, I believe, pro shares, Bloomberg oil contract, ETN. It needs to get above 938. You want to see it at 1015, 1020 by tomorrow or Monday. And the support, I would say, if it takes out today's low, I wouldn't want to be long. If it closes below, that's one. I'd be out if it took it out by the end of the day. That should be your benchmark. If you want to give it a little bit more room, 855. That's a long way down, but 855. If it closes under that, oil is not going to go up. It's going to retest the lows. But if it manages to have a very strong session tomorrow and Monday, oil then goes to 1011 is the 9-period moving average of the weekly. You want to see this very quickly, the UCO, you want to see trading at 921. You want to see it up in the 988 area very soon. And then crude oil is going to be a very big impetus maybe to see if the market can go together with crude oil to the upside for another move. It's going to be very important. The two, I think, should go together. Hope that helps you.
It does. I love you.
I love you too. Thank you. Thanks for calling. Bye-bye. Charlie Framingham, next town over from Newton. Okay, folks, I'll be back with Tom O'Brien later today. Please go to the front page of TFNN. Check out if I can just find it right there. Check out my webinar coming up on Tuesday. If ever it was timely, this is going to be it for two reasons. One, it's market timely, but mostly it's timely because we've stepped right into the coda phase. The coda phase means it can go for a while. It can go from 3 months to even a year on the upside. But we're going to be checking off every single week. What are we looking for a major, major top? We're not even close to it yet, I think. All right, folks, we can still pull back deeply coming up in September. But in the meantime, I'll be back with Tom O'Brien. Otherwise, I'll see you tomorrow. I'll be doing Larry's show at 9 and mine at 11. Have a great day. See you later on.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
This is TFNN.